Harris will be trained by Elder Staves in Gateshead.
Meet the Mormons. Young missionaries whose job is to convert us to their particular brand of Christianity. Run from Salt Lake City in Utah, it's an empire spanning 185 countries, including the UK. The world leader is Thomas S. Monson. Revered and saluted by thousands of church members, his appointment here was broadcast online to the 15 million Mormons around the world. To them, he's a living prophet who receives revelations directly from God. Mormons adhere to his every word.
I speak of missionary work. To you young men who are becoming elders, I repeat what prophets have long taught, that every worthy, able young man should prepare to serve a mission.
I wanted to make a film about the young missionaries who are expected to give up 2 years of their lives for the church. They call them ambassadors of God.
Talk with everyone. Everyone. Absolutely everyone.
Hi. Hi, you alright? You alright?
Yeah.
The promise is that you will know it's real. We're Mormons, what are Christians?
I was given unprecedented access because the church wanted me to make a film about their faith. But there's also much they like to keep secret and people find odd. Mormons perform baptisms for dead people and wear special underwear which they believe protects them from temptation and evil. Fundamentally, they believe Jesus went to America after his crucifixion. I was soon to realise this is a church anxious about its public image.
Good. We're from the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
Oh, no, thank you. No, thanks.
Okay, may I just...
Filming began in a car park on the outskirts of Coventry.
Hello.
This is Josh Field, the young man the church said I could film. Josh is 20, from Sussex, and is about to serve 2 years as a missionary in Leeds. Tonight he's going out with a friend to a Mormon dance.
Hi, I'm Sophie.
But someone else is here too, Des, a representative from the church's public relations department. He's going to be present for all the filming, listening to everything that I say to Josh and everything Josh says back to me.
I look so funny about that.
It was strange not being able to talk to Josh on my own.
What are the rules at these dances?
Standard Mormon rules. They're just like don't drink, don't smoke, come to make friends.
The music, how's it managed?
Well, it's just normal music that you'll hear in the charts, but if the DJ's any good, he'll like dub out all the bad words and stuff.
What sort of stuff would get played here then?
What sort of stuff? Just anything that's offensive, anything that's like sexually vulgar or anything like that, anything that drops swear words. Or, yeah, sexually suggestive. If you wouldn't play it in front of your mum, don't play it at the dance, maybe. I don't know.
Thousands of young Mormons attend dances like these most weekends. They grow up following a set of rules, which mean they don't smoke, drink alcohol, or even drink tea or coffee, because they believe God commanded them not to. But perhaps hardest of all, is the church's strict law of chastity.
Let me tell you something. I would advocate celibacy until marriage because it will deepen a relationship. I went on a date with this girl and we went to go watch a movie. And let me tell you, that was as fun as any form of sexual relationship could be. Because
you
I got...
You haven't had sex, presumably?
No, I haven't, but the thing is, I know the chemical equations of it. so I can guess.
Mormons are often accused of secrecy, partly because their temples are closed to anyone who isn't a Mormon. Rituals here are secret, and although the church released this footage as a way of being more open, no one will talk about what goes on here in any detail. On Sundays, Mormons attend their local chapels. Josh has been immersed in Mormon life since birth. The eldest of six children, his mother Mandy brought them all up as Mormons. Children are taught from an early age that they're different from other Christians. While they follow Jesus Christ, they also revere a man called Joseph Smith. He lived in upstate New York 200 years ago. An American who Mormons believe had a series of visions.
He saw a beautiful, bright light all around him. He saw Heavenly Father and Jesus Christ standing above him in the air. Heavenly Father pointed to Jesus and said, "This is my beloved Son. Hear him." Joseph asked Jesus which church he should join. Jesus told Joseph not to join any of the churches because they were all wrong. None of them was his church.
Mormons believe Joseph Smith was commanded by God to set up a new church because other Christians had gone astray. They claim theirs is the one true church.
I hope they call me on a mission when I have grown a foot or two.
For the last 7 months, Josh has been living with church members Leslie and David. They've been helping him prepare for his mission.
I mean, what do you think the public perception is of Mormons?
Oh, Mormons, oh, strange lot.
Oh, yeah, with the children, I've had lots of things people have asked me, you know, do Mormons eat sandwiches, you know, and all that sort of thing.
The law of chastity is keeping yourself sexually clean, so it basically means no sexual contact with yourself or anyone else until you're married to someone, then obviously with each other you may have sex. For me, self-control, it just hasn't been a problem whatsoever. Like, it's just literally sex drive just gone. Anything that was ever there, it's just gone. So for another 2 years, it's just not going to be a problem.
A world that's full of temptation, it can be challenging to stay virtuous, but it's worth it. When you obey God's commandment to be sexually pure, you prepare yourself to make and keep sacred covenants in the temple.
Josh had proved himself to be a good Mormon and worthy of serving a mission. Tonight he's invited me to film the moment he becomes a missionary. It's called Setting Apart. He'll leave behind his previous life and submit to a new and even stricter set of rules. For the next 2 years, he won't be able to use his first name. He'll be known as Elder Field. A simple embrace with the opposite sex will be banned, and he won't be allowed to see any of his friends or family for the entire 2 years.
Okay. Joshua Levi Field. By the authority of the Melchizedek priesthood, which we thy brethren hold, and in the name of our Saviour Jesus Christ, we set you apart to be a full-time missionary of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, to serve in the England Leeds Mission for a period of 24 months.
The Mormons, a church run from America, and one of the fastest growing religions in the world. In Britain, there are about 200,000 Mormons. He's coming to this training centre in Lancashire to learn how to be a missionary. Every year, 1,000 young Mormons attend from around the world. For a Mormon family, it's a rite of passage which involves saying goodbye for 2 years. Elder Field, previously known as Josh, has been sent here by his church leader, the man Mormons believe is a living prophet, Thomas S. Munson.
You stand on the threshold of your missionary opportunity, and I would add this thought: missionaries are not salesmen with wares to peddle. They are servants of the Most High God, with testimonies to bear, with truths to teach, and souls to save. The work is difficult. It is demanding. But I would like to bear witness to you young men that our Heavenly Father who calls you, and remember your call comes from a prophet of God, he will be with you, for this is his work, and you are on his errand. And he will bless you, for he has promised.
Thank you for your trust.
As well as the ban on seeing family and friends, missionaries are only allowed to phone home twice a year and can only send a letter once a week. The idea is they focus entirely on their mission. Church representatives are still insisting on following all the filming. They want to make sure their beliefs are clear. Mormons believe in the Bible, but they also have their Book of Mormon, which tells the story of how Jesus went to America after his resurrection.
It's called the Book of Mormon. It tells about people who lived in America many years ago. It also tells about Jesus Christ, the Son of God.
Invite others to come unto Christ by helping them receive the restored gospel through faith in Jesus Christ and his atonement, repentance, baptism, receiving the gift of the Holy Ghost, and enduring to the end.
These rules, these ways to live as missionaries to protect you, okay? And so follow them.
90 pages of the Lord's instructions cover everything, from what socks to wear and the need for deodorant to a ban on swimming.
But don't just study it, don't just live it, but learn to love it. Learn to love the guidelines that the Lord has set for you.
Missionaries are taught to view everyone they meet as someone in need of the gospel.
Onward, ever onward, as your glory is.
share the gospel with everyone, absolutely everyone. That right now, the Heavenly Father is preparing people to receive you and your message. And he's been preparing people for you to find. Who's preparing the hearts? Angels.
It was hard to understand why Elder Field would stay when he seemed so unhappy. But all young Mormon men grow up knowing the church expects them to serve a mission. It was a question of faith. Elder Field has finished his training and is ready to start his mission. Missionaries get sent all over the world. He's been sent to Leeds. As usual, church official Richard has come along too.
Elder Field. Good to have you.
President Lindley is in charge of the 250 missionaries in the northeast of England.
Just come in and maybe we can kneel down and have a prayer as we begin, if that's all right.
Yeah, of course.
Perhaps I could offer that prayer. Our Father in Heaven, I'm so thankful for the opportunity to welcome Elder Field into the mission on his first day. Pray that thy spirit would be with him throughout his mission, that he will be directed and prompted by the Spirit to accomplish his purpose as a missionary to invite other people to come under Christ. Tell me, Elder Field. Exciting time, the time that we all wait for.
Missionaries work in pairs. The new arrivals are about to find out who their companions will be.
Dear kind Heavenly Father, we pray that
straight away they were out on the streets
tonight, that we may be able to work with the Spirit and be able to find the people who are ready to hear about the gospel.
Hey friend, how are you? Hey, I'm Elder Bauman.
Yeah.
This is my friend, Elder Field. We're missionaries.
Yeah.
We're sharing a message about Jesus Christ and how his church is on the earth again.
Yeah.
Do you have beliefs for yourself, religious?
Yeah, about Sikh, so Sikh.
Oh, you're Sikh, yeah. Alright. What do you... I've met a few Sikhs, but I don't know what you believe in, actually.
I believe in God like anyone.
Alright.
It's God's, yeah.
It's amazing. Do you have, like... No problem. Do you know... Do you have another time? We can come more.
I'm already interested, I'm sorry.
Next one is yours.
It's the next morning. Elder Field is sharing a small flat with Elder Bauman and two other.
Let's sing 1, 2, 3 in 10 7.
Okay. How firm a foundation, ye saints of the Lord, is laid for your faith in his excellent word. Covered his veil or abounding in wealth.
Beautiful. Let's say, you want to pray?
I thought it's the exact same thing.
Missionaries are required to be with their companion, literally at all times. They must always be in the same room together, and the only time they can be apart is when they go to the bathroom. This way they can keep an eye on each other in case they're tempted to stray.
Jesus Christ, amen.
Amen.
They always sleep in the same room and get up and go to bed at exactly the same time as each other, because they must never even try to be alone. Each missionary is given just £29 a week to cover food and haircuts. They work unpaid, and they're expected to contribute £6,000 to the overall costs.
Me and my friend, we're missionaries.
Oh, sorry, we've got somewhere to be.
All right, take care. Hiya.
Mormon missionaries have to work 365 days a year, so for 2 years, they never get a whole day off.
Hi, you two, how are you doing? You having a good day?
They're set goals. In the first year, their target is to recruit 4 new converts.
Have you heard about the Book of Mormon before? Probably not.
To become a Mormon, you're expected to pay 10% of your income to the church.
About Jesus Christ.
Oh no, I'm sorry, dear. I go to St. Chad's and I'm very happy with that.
Oh, yeah. It's good.
Just a way of us showing our love and our commitment to him.
He's forbidden from reading books and newspapers, listening to the radio, watching television, going on the internet, going to the cinema, theatre, and nearly every other cultural activity.
Dear Father in heaven, we thank thee for the good night you have given us.
Hiya, mate. Hey, we share the Book of Mormon?
No, it's too nice.
Good.
Hey, I'm interested.
You still... to share a message about Jesus Christ?
No. Okay.
Nothing worth having is easy. No.
About the Book of Mormon before? Have you heard about the book before?
I just need to do some shopping, sorry.
Alright, hey, it just takes a few seconds, man.
Sorry.
Okay, great hat, by the way.
Have you ever heard about it?
If everyone believes in God.
Alright, hey, can I show you something?